Hello and welcome to New Trip Report. Today I'm in the capital of Sweden, the city of Stockholm. We are going on a day trip out of the city. Our goal is the municipality of Vaxholm, which is about a 50-minute bus ride northeast of the city center of Stockholm. Today I will show you how to get to and from Vaxholm, and I will show you a little bit of this beautiful small city. Besides using the car, you can get to Vaxholm from the Stockholm city center by public transport. As you can see, I took a combination of underground and regional bus to get to Vaxholm. It's a cheap and convenient way to get to Vaxholm, since you can buy a day ticket for the whole Stockholm area, and this is included in the price. There's another, more beautiful option to get to and from Vaxholm, and I will show you it in the end of the video. Vaxholm is a small city with about 5,000 inhabitants, and as I said before, it's northeast of the city of Stockholm. During the summer, Vaxholm is a popular place to go to, and a lot of people around Stockholm have a little cottage here. But Vaxholm is also the gateway for most of the boats going out to the Stockholm archipelago. I filmed this video just before Easter 2022, that means the season hasn't started yet. During the summer, and especially on weekends, Vaxholm can get very crowded. If you're here in Vaxholm, I recommend that you take a walk through the small city. If you look to the right, you can see the fortress, which you can visit. This video is not sponsored in any way. But the sign for the little cafe you see on the right hand side is the one my family loved the most. If you love cake, if you love to sit outside in beautiful surroundings, in the summer this is the place to go to. They have a nice Instagram account, take a look at them. Unfortunately, it was closed when we were there. They open in May and have opened during the summer. Everything in Vaxholm is in short walking distance. That is why the best way to explore this city is just walking around and get lost in the small streets. If you're into photography, I think this area gives a lot of opportunities to take beautiful pictures. By the way, this is the cafe I was talking about earlier. We are now in the very city center of Vaxholm and going toward the town square. The orange building on the right side is City Hall. When you turn to the right at the end of City Hall, you will end up in the city center, where you can find a lot of small shops and cafes. I would also recommend to go a little bit west of the city center, because you might find some hidden treasures there. As I mentioned earlier in the video, there's one more way to get to and from Vaxholm. For me, this is the best and most beautiful way to get here. You might have guessed it by now, it is a boat trip from Stockholm city center to Vaxholm and back. Especially if you're only in Stockholm for a short time, this is a great way to get a feeling of the archipelago. I have to tell you that this is not part of the public transport and you cannot use the day or 3 day ticket you can buy for the Stockholm region. If you take a look at the homepage of Vaxholmbolaget, which is operating these ferries, you can see what it will cost you. I think the price for one way trip was about 10 euros. I will post a link to Vaxholmbolaget down in the description of the video, together with other links that are related to the video. Quite a lot of ferries going from Vaxholm to Stockholm. The travel time on each ferry may be different because they have different routes and stop in different harbors. But the normal trip will take you around an hour. Again, in the summertime, on weekends, it might be very crowded also on the boats. If you want to know how much time you will need to visit Vaxholm, I think 5 to 6 hours should be enough. That includes transfer from the city center of Stockholm by underground bus or by boat to Vaxholm and back, and will leave you a lot of time to explore the city, sit down, take a coffee, eat some cake and enjoy yourself. That doesn't mean that you can't take longer time here or try to explore more of the archipelago from Vaxholm. There are a lot of boats going out there. Taking the boat will give you a great opportunity to see the beauty of this area from the water. I will take a break now and let you enjoy the views. We are now getting close to the city, passing the island of Djurgården. I could make one video only showing you what to do if you're in Stockholm for a short time. I just love this city. we are passing the islands of Kastellholmen and Skeppsholmen, two places I would recommend you take a little walk. What you can see here is the outside of Gamla Stan, the old town of Stockholm, and this is a place you have to visit if you are in Stockholm. The end of this trip will be on the opposite side of the Royal Castle, which you can see in the picture here. This will also mean that this trip is coming to an end. I can only recommend to visit Stockholm. I might do some more travel videos about Stockholm, maybe other cities in the future. Now it is time to say hey do and tack that you joined me on this trip. I hope you enjoyed this small trip report. If you haven't subscribed yet, now would be a good time to do so. And you're welcome to leave a like and comment. Thanks for watching, see you on my next trip report. Until then, remember, to travel is to live. See you all.